From the Tribune News Network, this is News Break. I'm Kirk Smith. Monday's top stories. We have the answer now. The COVID-19 emergency orders will stay in place for another 6 months at least. The Governor General signed the proclamation over the weekend, citing low vaccination numbers, the current third wave of the virus, and the expectation that the virus is going to be around for the foreseeable future among the reasons. Opposition leader Davis says his party cannot support the continued suspension of civil liberties. 61 cases confirmed for Friday, 50 for Saturday, most of them in the capital, where the numbers remain too high for health officials. 44 of Saturday's cases in the capital, 51 of Friday's, the others spread over several other islands. 43 persons are in hospital now, 6 of them in the ICU. There were 3 more confirmed deaths, taking that total to 220 now, and that is likely to increase. More than 20 other deaths are under investigation, 2 New Providence men and an Andros woman, the latest confirmed victims. The vaccination effort continues, but it slowed significantly. Opposition leader Davis believes more education is needed.
First strategy would be to ensure to educate our people to the need for them to be vaccinated and let them know that there was a race to defeat this enemy we call the virus, right? It's a race between vaccinating our people and stopping the spread at the same time.
This is News Break from the Tribune News Network. It's being criticized, but the Ministry of Works moves ahead with its demolition of new structures in the Abaco shanty town, The Farm. At least 10 were demolished over the weekend. Police busy over the weekend. They're investigating 2 murders and the death of a man found with gunshot wounds. All of the incidents in the Capitol, all of the victims are male. 3 persons in hospital with gunshot wounds, one of them listed as critical. Drug agents in Grand Bahama looking for 2 men in connection with the discovery of a marijuana farm on the island with about 7,000 plants on it, worth about $7 billion. Tributes coming in for well-known broadcaster and former MP Sir Charles Carter. He died over the weekend. Sir Charles was well-known for his Young Bahamian show. Miss Bahamas did not place in the Miss Universe pageant held last night in Florida. South America dominated. Mexico, Brazil, and Peru took the top spots. Details of the day's top stories in the Tribune newspaper on the streets first thing in the morning. Stay up to date online at tribune242.com. Now the Tribune's AccuWeather update, a service of insurance management. The frontal system has now cleared the area. Partly sunny today, highs in the low to mid-80s, 83 at Freeport, 84 in the capital, 84 at Matthewtown. No marine advisories, winds generally 10 to 15 knots, the sea's 2 to 4 feet. Low tide now, the next high around noon. Turning partly cloudy tonight, lows from the low to upper 70s. For complete weather information, check the Tribune's weather page. For your insurance needs, you want to call Insurance Management. We're approaching the hurricane season. Insurance Management urges you to complete your preparations early and ensure that your home and contents coverage is up to date. Call them today. With more than 40 years in business, nobody does it better than Insurance Management. This is News Break from the Tribune News Network.
Do you want to increase your sales? Then advertise your business in the Tribune, the leading newspaper in circulation. Reach the market that will keep your registers ringing. Give your business the maximum exposure at an affordable investment. Advertise in our Home Buyer's Guide, Insight, Women, or Obituary sections. Let us help you get your business to the Bahamas and to the world with our online advertising spots. Professional advertising reps are waiting to offer you advertising packages to suit your budget. And consultations are free. The Tribune, your answer to increased sales. Call our sales department today, 502-2394, or visit us on Shirley Street. The Tribune, the people's paper, biggest and best.
Monday's World News headlines, the Middle East conflict now in its 7th day, and despite diplomatic efforts, there's no end in sight. Israel carried out more airstrikes over the weekend, and Hamas sent more rockets into Israel from Gaza. The death toll higher on the Palestinian side, more than 100 killed, more than 50 of them are children. Only 8 casualties have been confirmed by Israel. Diplomatic efforts to end the conflict continues. Finally, the coronavirus numbers are coming down in India, that as Britain lifts more restrictions, returning to indoor dining beginning today. Tribune's gas tracker prices to start the week, Shell $4.91, Esso $4.94, Rubis $4.89 per gallon in the capital. Now your sports notes brought to you by the Tribune Sports Section. Big start for J.J. Jonquel Jones on her return to the WNBA. Two games, two wins for the Connecticut Sun, and good numbers for her. Read about it in the Tribune Sports. Find out where DeAndre Ayton and the Suns line up in the NBA playoffs. The regular season completed over the weekend.